Good morning, everyone. What's going on? It is time for another preview of which is Bleach, episode 9, The Drop. Now, there is some big speculation with this episode, as many of you can kind of guess by the title, as many of you have probably gone back even to the manga to check where we're going to be adaptating. And I think some of those things might be more disappointing than you think, but I generally think it's going to be a great episode overall. So sit back, relax, click and like and subscribe, all that good stuff, and comment down below about what you think about my potential predictions about this episode. But with that being said, let's get into it, shall we? Now, of course, after the last episode kind of ending a little bit abruptly in regards to the Soul King and Renji, I do feel like this episode is going to be a little bit better in terms of things going on and in terms of learning about the lore of Bleach. I feel like we are going to get back into the Hot Springs scene, and of course, everyone talked about Buff Khan and Ruki from last episode. These can be kind of salvaged in their own way in this episode. Call it copium, call it hopium, whatever you want to say. I'm not fussed or bothered either way, because I understand the tone that it's going for and I don't think it's that big of a deal. However, if it's there, it's there. I think it will make people happy. I don't think it's going to affect Masaki or Yodowichi later on down the road, but we'll have to see when it comes to those episodes. So before I get into the screenshots, my predictions for this episode is going to be we're going to get the Heart Springs. Hopefully we get a little bit more in regards to what the Heart Springs can do. Hopefully a little bit of backstory in regards to Kisuke Urahara. And hopefully as well, when we get the eye catching scenes, you know, those little title cards where there's a lot of text on the wall and that isn't ever translated by Viz or by Disney whatsoever. Hopefully there's nothing in those title cards that are deemed relevant, because in the last episode in regards to, you know, someone like Renji and Ikaku about their Bankai, those were actually mentioned within those title cards, but we just never knew because we can't read it. So it's easily mistakable, to be honest, but I'm glad that they put those things in those title cards. A little bit of extra information that maybe wasn't deemed for the episode, but is nice nonetheless in the title cards. And hopefully, when the Blu-rays come out, maybe they get translated there. One can hope. But as I said, Heart Springs with Renji. Probably going to get some really cool back and forth with Ichigo and him. Also, we're going to get some Renji in this episode as well from the screenshots you're going to be seeing shortly. And hopefully, those little nitpicks from the last episode that I had are kind of redeemable within this one. Again, bringing up Kisuke and his hot tubs as well, or Hot Springs. I felt like that's a nice little detail that should be added in terms of like maybe foreshadowing. Even if Kubo at the time didn't come up with it, we'll never really know. But still, it'd be a nice little thing to throw in there for nostalgia reasons for the fans. Next and foremost, we're going to be getting Haki Fune again from the screenshots we're going to be seeing shortly. It was seen that we are going to be getting the introduction with her, her abilities, what she is able to do as well. And hopefully, as long as that food looks delicious, I'll have no complaints in regards to Haki Fune in general, because that is a good kind of section for comedy of where it's needed, and a little bit in regards to a little bit of Renji and Ichigo banter back and forth, and a little bit of their characters kind of shining out a little bit from not seeing each other for so long as well, since, well, the Fullbring arc. But still, it'd be nice to see more of the light-hearted scenes in regards to that. And then following up from that, Namaya Oetsu in regards to the Zanpakuto, hopefully being kind of relevant in terms of what Renji's Zanpakuto gone through, and also about Ichigo's as well, and a little bit of drama between, you know, Renji and Ichigo versus the Yasuchi, maybe. Am I asking too much? However, we might, you know, if memory serves me correctly, in this episode get a bunch of Namaya's harem, you know, all those Yasuchi girls, we're going to get to see them, hopefully, fingers crossed. So that's going to be really fun to watch and enjoy as well. But I am really interested in Namaya's scene specifically. Maybe not this episode, but later on down the road when we potentially get into, maybe if Hiramitsu is smart enough and can slide it in there, maybe, you know, when Ichigo does the thing for my manga readers out there, hopefully we get a little bit of hint of Tokinada later on in the series. Maybe not even this core, maybe later on, who knows. For my light novel boys, you know what I'm talking about. But regardless of what, it's going to be really interesting to learn about the Zanpakuto again. It's going to be really interesting to see what people's reactions are in regards to the Yasuchi, maybe even more so Renji and Ichigo's journey into their kind of inner self as well. That would be really cool and interesting. And then to end off the episode, I generally think we're then going to be getting our title card, The Drop, because I do believe we're going to be getting what everybody wants, and that is KENPACHI'S versus KENPACHI. But I do believe it is definitely going to be either a post-credit scene or at the very end minute or two towards the episode. So leading into episode 10, that's my prediction here. I don't think we're going to be getting it this one. I know that people are probably very speculated towards that, because it does kind of hit smack bang in the middle of where this episode would be, but I feel like it is going to get moved over towards the end, and that's fine. Moving content like that is kind of what I expect for this, just to keep the flow on par. So let's get into the synopsis of this episode, and then let's talk about the screenshots a little bit more. Ichigo is brought to the Reio Palace by Squad Zero, as we know. At the first Kirin, he is treated by Tanjiro Kurenji in an unexpected way. However, the effect is outstanding, and Ichigo, who is healed from the wounds of his body, goes with Renji to Namaya and Hikifune Kiriko. There, another unexpected hospitality awaits them. Meanwhile, at the Serate, Kuroku, who has been appointed as the new commander-in-chief and the first commander, is talking about a plan to have in front of the Central 46 room in front of him. Granted, as always, these translations are a bit dodgy, but you kind of understand where we're going. Now, of course, I didn't mention about Kuroku. I feel like we're going to get some bits here and there in regards to his promotion, about how he conducts himself and how he moves forward. And of course, we're going to get a little bit in regards to Central 46, which one of the screenshots does show. So let's get into the screenshots as it is. First and foremost, we're going to be getting Hikifune or Hakifune, and yeah, there's not really much to say other than her face close up. It looks like most of these images in general look really clean and on point, so nothing to complain about in this kind of regard. But yes, this is Hikifune, and if I had to imagine for this screenshot in particular, I would say this is probably her in the kitchen in front of the stove, because it has like this this bright effect coming from under her, so I imagine that's like a flame from her cooking. So that's kind of my shout here, but again, lovely image and lovely panel in here. Next off, we have Kyoraku Shunsui, which I believe this is probably his kind of interaction with Central 46 and what he plans to do with Kenpachi, as well as Unohana, and his plans going forward in regards to the war. This should take up, you know, a slight good amount of time in terms of the episode. It's just going to be interesting to see all the voice actors' jobs in regards to Central 46 on their outrage in terms of things, and also kind of giving us a nice stark thing with Unohana. I love how they're not showing the images of Unohana in this, but it seems as that is going to be definitely an episode kind of shot to have in terms of getting people excited. This was kind of hinted towards last episode, where if you watch my review, where there was a bit of a blur effect where Kyoraku was looking at Unohana and Kurinji's conversation. So I'm very excited to see what people's reactions are in regards to this. Next and foremost, these are in no order, obviously, is that we have Renji, which seems to have one of his eyes shown this time rather than both of them closed. I don't know how, I should have mentioned this in a review, I don't know how you have both your eyes kind of incapacitated when Byakuya literally took on millions of cherry blossoms being Zanbanzakura, but only lost one eye or damaged one eye, while Renji, on the other hand, had both of his eyes taken out and he just got drop kicked by Master Masculine. So sure, Renji, you don't help yourself sometimes, mate. But again, this is in the Heart Springs. This is, I imagine, the exact shot where Kurenji gives him the nice little uppercut to the stomach. So I'm very excited to see how well they do that. Is it going to be well animated? Is there going to be a nice impact shot on that? And I hope so, I really do. Next one is Kurenji with, again, the towel on his head. I'm hoping that this is him yelling at Ichigo for not having his towel on his head, because he's going to die if he doesn't keep the balance of healing incorrectness, and the Reishi just bursts out of his head and kills him. Yeah, it's silly, but it's little details like that I personally like a lot. And then the next one is Ichigo and Renji kind of having a bit of banter. It looks like they're doing it in the sky, like they're falling down from the sky, which I imagine, hopefully, this is a scene of which Buff Khan can come to the rescue. So I do like this banter as they're falling essentially to their death in a way. So all of these shots so far look really clean and really special, and I'm very excited for this episode. I'm more of a plot driven kind of episode, and with the cliffhangers as well. So do I think that this is going to be a good episode? The staff, I have no problem with the staff. Hiramitsu again, awesome, goaded, raw. We're going to have Asakura on here, who is mainly known for their Boruto work and doing some good Boruto episodes in terms of the storyboard as well as the episode direction. So I have some good high hopes for this. The last episode direction, maybe I was being a little bit too harsh on, because that was their first ever time as an episode director. So, you know, that was their first ever episode in general throughout their career. So maybe I was being a little bit harsh, but, you know, nonetheless, they did a great job. And I have some high hopes for Asakura to really pull through on this episode and really make it exciting and well-paced. And I think that's what we can all ask. So do you agree with my prediction of how things are going to go? I think, you know, this is going to be a good amount of content for this episode, and then we're going to get back into the suspense and back into some hype stuff in regards to, you know, 11, 12 and 13. 10, 11, 12, 13. Especially as I do believe, and I'll say it here first, I do believe that 11, 12 and 13 may be everything but the rain arc. Well, maybe half of episode 13, because I guess they've got to get back into present day, so to say. But, and then I do believe episode 10 is going to be full KENPACHI versus KENPACHI. So, we'll see if I'm right. Other than that, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of this episode. Do you think I'm right? Anything else you want to see? Do you want to see Buff Khan? Do you want to see Rookie as Peach? I know the answer, but be realistic. Are you that seriously pressed against it? Other than that, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.